What is going on, guys? Sugar Knight Leader here. Benson, you can edit this in the beginning if you want to. Or later in the end. We just had our first death in a grinding session. Shaw, unfortunately, has passed away while we were grinding, getting ready to fight against Gardenia in the next episode, or in the current episode, actually, as I'm recording this little blurb. We were fighting these two trainers here. These two trainers right here in a double battle. It was Shaw and Rihanna going against them, against a Vespa Queen and a Priplup. I thought we had it. The Vespa Queen was consistently using pursuits on Shaw, and I did not heal. I decided to instead switch out while I was speed up training. And unfortunately, that was the mistake. Well, that was the one mistake. So, yeah. Shaw is, unfortunately, our first major L, and it is in a grinding session. And that hurts. I didn't really want to use Shaw. I won't lie. I didn't want to use Shaw, so it's not as big of a hit as someone else on the team could have been. I'm just not happy it happened then. I'm really not happy it happened. Especially during the grinding session when I'm not recording and you guys aren't actually watching it happen. Content-wise, that's not that great. But at the same time, I gotta follow the rules. I was considering even just not letting it happen, but, you know, no, that's not how it's gonna go. Shaw's dead. Shaw's gone. And we gotta accept that. We gotta accept that reality. Oh my god, it fucking sucks! To put someone into the box, man, Shaw's gonna be... I feel like Shaw's gonna matter to some extent. Hello, 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 everyone. What is going on? It is your boy, Shogun and Lady here, back again. And today, we are here with another episode of our Pokemon Platinum Randomized Nuzlocke here on the channel. Now, in the last episode, we handled a little bit of story stuff and got some encounters along the way. But now, we are here to face Gardenia. And it's going to be, hopefully, an easier battle. Now, if you guys have been keeping updated, I won't dwell too much, but unfortunately, we did lose a team member. But the squad, in my opinion, is overall stronger now. And we are here. Ooh, excuse me. Our level is grinded up, and we are prepared to face Gardenia. Alright, so with that said, let's get right into the team recap here. Now the team is a little bit different, if you remember correctly from the last episode. I barely remember the team difference, just because it's been a while since I've recorded, but you know what, team recap either way. So, we have Verdante, our Leafeon, at level 22. I decided to grind the entire team up to level 22, because that should be Gardenia's Aces level. If not, we'll be over-leveled, or under-leveled, depending on what happens. Either way, Verdante is running Tail Whip, Quick Attack, Razor Leaf, and Sand Attack. We have Kingsley, our level 22 Nidorino, rocking Horn Attack, Peck, Poison Sting, and Rock Smash. We have Rihanna, our level 22 Ampharos, with Flash Cannon, Conspore, Thundershock, and Thunder Wave. We have ACDC, that's right, ACDC is on the squad, our level 22 Skarmory with Agility, Drill Peck, Sand Attack, and Fury Attack. We have Bryonic, our Dragonair, our lovely starter, rocking Dragon Rage, Slam, Thunder Wave, and Twister. And I believe that's finally, yes, finally, we have Tilly, the level 22 Glalie, rocking Headbutt, Icy Wind, Protect, and Bite. Alright, so I am thoroughly, in my opinion, unprepared for this fight. I'm sorry, guys, I should have mentioned, we also gained a few encounters off screen that I do want to talk about real quick, and I guess this will be my lead into a little bit of a spoiler for everyone. So, unfortunately, as seen here, Shaw has passed away. The clip will either be in the previous episode or in this episode, but you will see. I will talk about it, so we're gonna skip it for now. But we did gain a few encounters while we were on the way. These three G's right here. So, first off, we have Pengu, the Empoleon, at level 5. We ran all the way back to Twin Leaf Town while we were grinding to catch this guy. Little lake there. He only has Tackle, Growl, and Bubble. Don't know what happened there, but Benson, if anything did happen, I'd bet out. If not, keep this in and be a funny joke. Next on the list, we have Boston, the Rhyhorn. We found him on round 219. I'm pretty sure I caught no one there. Running blanks on it now. But I believe that is the route directly under Sand Gem Town. Little bit of a surfing place there. She is rocking Horn Attack, Tail Whip, Snop, and Fury Attack. And finally, we were able to make it back to get our fossil at the Mining Museum, which was a Staraptor. I think that's an I, yes. Sturry the Staraptor. Sturry has Quick Attack, Wing Attack, Double Team, and Endeavor. But those are other guys. I didn't want to add any of them to the team. I didn't per se need a Rock Type or anything like that. If anything, the team is weak to ground, so maybe the Flying Type would have been helpful. But either way, I decided against them, at least for now. But let's just get on in there. Hopefully we can get this Gardenia stuff done and out of the way so we can handle Galactic. Because that building is going to be fun. I am a little worried for this fight, honestly. Especially because I have to go through and beat all of these trainers. But we're going to get through it. And I think it's going to go hopefully pretty good. But knock on Airwood breaks. Alright, so director here starts with a fucking Alexia. Alright, looks like we're already in pretty good shape. So, let's go move Rizzly. Oh, I thought Rizzly never missed? Oh, well, now I gotta find out. Now I definitely gotta find out. 95. Oh, alright then. Well, it's Dab, so I do with it again. Alright, well, let's talk question of the day. What is your most memorable Pokemon battle you've ever been in? It can either be friend, in the games, whatever suits your fancy. So for me, I have a couple here and there. The biggest one that I can remember right now was, it was actually in my playthrough, ooh, that's nice to have. I probably should have switched out. You got Protect, don't you? Shit. Supersonic, okay. But it was actually in a playthrough of Diamond when I was a kid. I might not be remembering. Oh, you are part water type, I forgot. But, I was on my way to what is for Diamond and Pearl, the 5th gym. I can't remember her name right now. Fantina? The ghost type gym leader. For Gen 4. I was on my way to battle her. If I remember correctly, the team I had was a Monferno, a Sarivia. I think I had a Bidoo. Crap, what else? I might not be remembering this correctly at all, so if that's the case, please ignore me. But, crap, I can't remember the name. I had something else. But, basically, I went into the gym battle, you know, I was ready. I thought I was gonna do great. But, most of my team ended up dying and getting utterly destroyed. But, I was able to come back with my, Azumarill. Oh my god. What the fuck does Regirock know at level 15, and will it be a death? It does know explosion still. That's really, really terrifying. Does anybody have... Oh, no. AC/DC is going to be the safest bet. AC/DC is going to be the safest bet. Alright. Please don't use explosion. Please. Okay. Now that it's been hit, does it still get protected from explosion? Because it doesn't have any... I don't have any steel-type moves. Ooh, it doesn't get protected from rock, though. I might have just made a bad play. It has clear body. I mean, that is the dumb move of the trainer to do, too, right? I just grinded this team up, man. Do I want to switch back? Or can I kill it with Drill Tech? I live in fear of that explosion. I live in so much fear of that explosion right now. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to cut off my story, guys. Oh, shit. Keep using Rockstar. Keep using Stomp. So, I looked into it. It has Explosion, Stomp, and Rock Throw. And only one of them is actually triggered. That's it. You know what to do. Oh no! Oh! Oh! Well... That wasn't as scary as I thought. Alright. Well, anyway. Thank you, AC/DC, for being the tank that you are. Should have figured that wouldn't have got a lot of damage from a move of that nature. Steel type resists normal type, if I remember correctly. Damn, I see way too many legendaries, man. I see way too many. Way too many legendaries for my own good. Oh my god. But back to memorable battles. I was battling her. My soul team died. But the only Pokemon that survived was my Azumarill, and I remember because it was able to beat her. Not even with stab move. I barely used water gun. Because I was under the assumption that water gun wouldn't do much damage at all. I'm not sure if I tested it or anything like that, but I just assumed. But I was able to land some ferocious rollouts. Which I guess is the real kicker, huh? I'm going back and healing. That my life just flashed from my eyes. And we haven't even fought Gardenia yet. Oh my god. I think I'm gonna buy some potions or something while I'm out here. But anyways, that Azumarill won me that gym battle, and I have had so much respect for it since. I really, really like Azumarill. I don't know if it's actually any good competitively or anything like that, but Azumarill has a special little place in my heart, and that's all that really mattered, I suppose. Oh my god, I always forget this theme exists. Oh wait, I am like super stacked, aren't I? Wow, are you gonna wait and burn you? I am actually playing this Nuzlocke how you should be, I think. I mean, don't quote me. I'm no expert. But I'm doing my best, and that's what truly, truly matters. I feel like I sound sad already. Oh, shit. I'm still thinking about Shaw, man. I did mention in the little tidbit about Shaw that I was not super fond of using it, even though thinking about it would have added a little more intrigue to the series. I would have loved to use it. I would have loved to use Shaw a little longer. Zatu would have been a great in my opinion. The psychic flying type, I would have enjoyed that. I definitely would have enjoyed that. But fortunately, all things are meant to be. And we gotta keep moving forward. For Shaw's sake. We're gonna win this. We're gonna win. We're gonna defeat this battle. We're gonna win this battle for Shaw. Shaw is watching down on us right now from the heavens. Shaw knows we can do it. We lost Shaw. Fuck. And we gained other people. We gained a Brigante. ACDC. I'm not exactly sure who we gained, to be honest with you. But we gained nonetheless, and that's all that matters. That we're gonna be able to get this dub, knock on Airwood breaks, and it's gonna be good. It's gonna do this for the squad. The squad is gonna go on with this. Fuck off. Later on. Is it later? I'm not exactly sure how that's pronounced. What else is going on that I can talk about? Way after the posting of this video, or way before, I guess I should say, you guys will have seen, hopefully, the first few episodes of Shadow of the Colossus. That's the main Let's Play on the channel right now. As of recording this video was recorded on December 1st, actually, which is surprising. We're almost done with the year. Almost done. We're getting there. But nonetheless, it's been a great year for the channel. I really am happy for all the support we've received, and thank you for everyone who has been along for every journey. You know, if I remember correctly, I might be wrong. I'd have to fact check myself on this. Remenzin, you can post the fact check on the screen if you would like to. I believe we finished God of War this year, completed Concrete Genie. A lot's happened for the channel in such a short amount of time, which is just so, so awesome, and I'm glad I continue to keep growing. I'm gonna put in Brian Egg first. That Dragon Rage might be pivotal. But looking back, this has been all things considered, this has been a great year. Great year for the channel and just for everything, and I really appreciate you guys for that. But enough of the Sobby love story. It's Gardenia time. It's Gardenia time. Now you kept me waiting. I'm a turn of St. Gym leader, Gardenia, the grass type master. I'm not sure if that's still her voice or not, but if it is, then yeah, if it isn't, don't worry about it. When I first saw you, I was convinced you'd find your way to me. My hunch was right on the moody. Yes, sirree, you have a winning aura about you. Time to fuck your shit up. So anyway, this will be fun. Let's have our battle. Not Noel. Alright, Entrepreneur Noel. Oh, fuck me. Oh my god, this is gonna go awfully. I sent in the wrong person already. Alright, let's see if we can get off a T-Wave. Oh my fucking god. It paralyzed me. Oh, you can't be serious. All right, Brian, Nick, you're getting right the fuck out of there. We're not even gonna give him a try. We're fucking up this laddie ass. Holy shit. Fuck you and your dragon breath. I'm probably gonna get paralyzed again. God. That did a lot more damage than I wanted. Oh, safeguard? Okay, I guess. What is that? Not a lot of status elements to be inflicted? Oh my god, Gardenia's already giving me a run for my money and we just started. Yo! Fucking Tilly Dog! I swear to god, yo, I got a new respect for Glalie. Let's fucking go! Oh my god. Oh my fucking god. Jesus, Brian Nick almost just got the fucking Glalie clappy. Oh my god. Thank Jesus for Tilly. Thank Arceus for Tilly. Spoink, boy, get your ass in here. We better fuck up a spoink, little bouncy pig looking ass. Bite. One hit. Oh! The crit would have mattered. Waste your super potion. Come on, get out of here. Come on. Oh, didn't even hear you full way. Bitch, you're gone. You are. No, you're not. Oh my god, are you serious? Fucking headbutt this game. Get this spoink out of my face. Be gone, Tilly is holding it down once again. Oh my lord. Dodrio. Tilly, I want to give you some more spotlight time. Let's give it to somebody new. Verdante, get your ass out here. Oh, Dodrio's a bird. Did I just make a pivotal mistake? He's not the... Yeah, shut up. Did I just make a mistake? Fuck, never mind. Verdante, get back in here. Verdant. Brianna, you're up. I don't know what Dodrio knows. I'll tell you what we know, though. This thing... Perfect, I don't even have to bother paralyzing you, bitch. Oh, man. This battle... From the get-go was... Yes! Revenge for almost killing Brian Nick! Revenge! Yes! Oh my god. The OG's holding this battle down. Tilly coming clutch once again. Oh my god. Yes, shut up, Gardenia. Get the fuck out of my face. I must have... Oh my god. That was stressful. Now, I might have said it before, but you're really tough. Wasn't it hard for you to raise your Pokemon and be so good? Like you would not believe, girl. Like you would not believe. I guess that's a measure of how much you love your Pokemon. In recognition of that, I proudly grant you this. We got the Forest Badge. Two down, yes. Amazing. With the Forest Badge, your Pokemon can use the hidden move cut outside battle. Now that you have two team badges, all Pokemon receiving trades will obey you up to level 30. I've also got something else. It's a gift from me. TMA6. It contains Sucker Punch. That means you'll never use it. The heavier the foe, the more damage this move will cause. It's Australian now. Oh, just get me out of here. I don't want anything to do with her anymore. Be gone. Let us be gone. Oh my god. Woo! So, we got some time left in the episode. So we are gonna attempt to tackle the rest of, or all of, the Platinum Building. Because I don't want to make this episode a little bit shorter. I don't need it to be lacking in content after that stressful moment in history. Oh my god. That was... Man, thank God for Tilly. Thank Arceus for shit. Thank Arceus for Tilly, man. That was wild. That is absolutely ridiculous. Alright, someone needs to learn Cut. Where's the move deleter? Alright, cool. ACDC is gonna learn it. Man, I got two new members, and they didn't even really participate at all, really. I'll take 50 with 95 accuracy over Fury to 15 with 85 accuracy. At least for now. Alright. Let's go crazy. Let's go fucking bonkers, yep. We're on the high of defeating Gardenia. Or Noelle, in our case, I guess. But I'll be honest, the real reason I was so worried about battling her, other than, you know, important battles just tend to feel, have that extra weight. Are you serious? Fuck this game. Anyways, but the reason I was so terrified is because my friends and I were actually doing a Platinum playthrough all together on our own. And I got to this place. I got to, Evergreen City, or wherever we are. And Gardenia utterly destroyed my team. And then I went into Galactic and I got even more destroyed. So I was terrified going in here. But no. Hello! It is me! Me! Haha! Have I startled you? Yes! I am, after all, an officer of the International Police. So hold it! It is only natural that I be a master of disguise! Take that! Invisibly, you are a first-rate trainer. Of that, I am very aware. I therefore will think you will be okay, but I must warn you to be careful anyway. Also, hold it! Word of advice. This building, it has two stairs, one of them a trap, it must be, but the crooks of Team Galactic. They do not adhere to, how I say, smart. There should be an easy way to tell the stairs apart. Ha ha ha! Never figured it out. I never truly figured it out. Other than it's probably just the people that you have to battle. I want my bike out. I want to be able to keep going. Yep. The path you choose leads to glory. Oh, the signs, huh? Yep, that makes much more sense than wherever the battles are. Well, I gotta train the team up. I mean, I could've used Blizzard the Grinding Session and start the next episode against the Galactic Boss, but... Alright, double battles have proven to be fatal so far. I mean, only one of them, but like... Doesn't mean I wanna take chances. What is with these people being so goddamn powerful? Like, this hurts, man. Alright, Brian, Nick, show them how it's done. Twister! Hopefully I sound nice, but this is nothing that I have to worry about. Alright. It ate that up. And it ate that up. Oh. Petty old rage, I guess? Yo, leave Kingsley alone, dog. Leave my boy Kingsley alone. He did nothing to you. He's just trying to play his best and survive for his friend. You know what, Shaw? Looking back, I think Shaw was watching us. I think Shaw was on our side to make sure we were... Oh my god, that did nothing. On our side to make sure we were okay. Because otherwise, we were probably getting fucked. Towards Hera. Alright. Alright, Kingsley, get back in the ball. We're going to bring out AC/DC for some action. Hopefully this Dragon Rage kills Dustmore. Perfect, perfect. Dragon Rage still proving to be pivotal. Ooh, that's risky. Ah, no, its defense is up now, huh? Oh, that's very Galactic Lake right there. Toxic Curve, huh? Alright, we're gonna double team the Torchair real quick, just in case. Perfect. That should kill. Even with the defense base. That's what's up. Alright. Now, hopefully this Toxic Curve does nothing scary to Brian. Because AC/DC should be fine against any poison or attacks. Bane attack, huh? Well, too bad you get fucked. Too bad we fuck you anyway. Eat shit. Eat shit. Eat shit and die. Get out of this. Be gone. Eat shit and die. They're called lazy. I just saw that. Alright, eat shit in that. What is this? I mean, I guess, right? Let's see what our lazy Kate has to offer us. Yes, Brian A. Push through. For Shaw. Fuck. Yes. All right, Brian A. Come on. Ugh, what a G. right. Not bad, not bad. But you know what, guys? We're actually going to end this episode right here. Eterna! Wow, I can't believe I forgot the name. Oof, that's rough. But if you guys like this episode, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe if you have not already. Keep yours, ring the bell, or put the bell on, so you'll know of any future uploads and all that junk. Oh man, really appreciate you guys for coming out if you're still watching. But that's gonna end it here. Thanks again for watching, guys. This is Showdown Leader, signing off.